السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
وعليكم السلام.
إن شاء الله. Before going into our lesson, right, let's have a look on these slides. Okay, these slides is talking about two things. In English, right, we know there are two type of sentences, correct? One is verbal sentence, another one is nominal sentence. It's common in English also, okay? Verbal sentence will have a verb and doer of the verb and an object where the verb has been placed or acted. In nominal sentence is a beginning, a topic. In English, we will call it as a subject. The subject will follow with information, which will we say in English as a predicate. For example, okay, since we are learning a noun in this book one, we will focus on nominal sentence. Okay, verbal sentence, inshallah, we will look at it in the book two. Nominal sentence, for example, right, if you say the house is bigger, okay, if you look at this, is this a nominal sentence or verbal sentence? Nominal sentence, okay. In this sentence, there is a subject. This is a subject which we are going to talk in this sentence, okay. We can say it as a topic also, a topic we are going to talk about in this sentence. What is the topic we have taken in this sentence? The house. Okay, then what we'll say? Okay, you have chosen a topic of the house. Tell me the information about the house. This is the information. In English, it is called predicate in English grammar. Information. Okay, so the house is a subject or a topic which we are going to speak about in this, in that sentence. The message is called as predicate information. Okay, about this subject, about this subject or topic. So all nominal sentence will have two parts. One is subject, a topic. Another one is information about the topic. In grammar, we will say predicate. This is in English, okay? Similarly, the same thing in Arabic. In Arabic, this subject is called as mubtada'un. How we call? Read it. Mubtada'u. Mubtada'un. Okay. Mubtada'un. The information, the predicate in Arabic, we will say as a khabar. Khabarun. Okay. Mubtada'un. Khabarun. So all the sentence will have two parts, regardless of whether all the nominal sentence will have two parts. The first part is subject, and the second part is predicate. In Arabic, subject will called as mubtada'un, mubtada. The predicate, the information, will be called as khabar, khabarun. Tanween, okay? Khabarun, khabar. You can start as a khabar. Okay, now I got it. If you say, do you have any doubts in this slide? Do you understand?
Yes.
Okay, no doubts. Can we go to the next slide? Okay. So now we know in English there are two parts, subject and predicate. Similarly, in Arabic we will call it as a mubtada and khabar. Now you look at this Arabic word. Arabic sentence, not word. Word is, this is the word, this is the word. This is the word, this is the word. For example, this is the word, word, word. But this is sentence. Similarly, this is sentence. Sentence, word, word, word. Okay, good. Hope you understand. Now, these two are nominal sentence. Have a. So this is the subject. This is the topic. Or we are looking at something and we are going to talk about that object. This is miftahun. This is the information about this subject, about this topic. So in Arabic, the subject is called as mubtada'un. The khabar will called as khabarun. Okay, sorry, the information will called as khabar. So this is mubtada and this is khabar. Okay, then come to a second example. Al qamisu jadidun. The shirt is new. In this sentence, we are going to talk about the shirt. Okay, this is the subject, a topic we have taken in this sentence. Okay, what is the information about the topic? It is jadidun. That is the information. So this is mubtada khabar. Al-qamisu mubtada, jadidun khabar. In English, if you say subject, predicate. Hadha mubtada miftahun khabar. In English, subject, predicate, or topic, information. Any doubts? Okay. Some more information you should aware about mubtada and khabar. Now you know what is mubtada means, what is khabar means. Okay, in Arabic you have to know few more information about this mubtada and khabar. This mubtada always be definite. Always be a definite. Hada means already, it's not indefinite, it's a definite. This you are pointing to something. In common words, mubtada should have al. Should have al. Okay? And khabar will usually be a indefinite. Khabar will usually be a indefinite. That means nakira. Mubtada should be a ma'rifa. Khabar should be a nakira. So that's why you have to write a al whenever you start a Arabic sentence, Arabic nominal sentence. For example, if you say, qamisun, qamisun jadidun, jadidun. It's wrong. Why? Pakaian jadidun is correct. Shirt is new, but mubtada should be definite, ma'arifa. So it should have alif lam here. Okay? Now, in second example, you say al-qamisu al-jadidu al-jadidu al-qamisu al-jadidu. Shirt new. Can we say shirt is new? No. This will not become a nominal sentence in Arabic because mubtada should be a ma'rifa. Okay, right. But khabar will usually be a indefinite. Then wrong. There may be some exceptions, but which will not come oftenly. Commonly, that's why usually be a. Here is, look at the keywords. Always, usually. Always means always. Usually be most commonly, 90%, 95%. It will be a nakira. Nakira means alif lam should not have. So if you write al-qamisu al-jadidu and you translate as this is a new shirt, wrong. It comma new comma it will not become a nominal sentence. So what you have to do, you have to remove the al from the khabar information, because the khabar usually should be a indefinite. So this is the correct one. This is the correct one. Al-qamisu jadidun. Al-qamisu jadidun. Okay. Good. Then second, one more information you should know about it, about the mubtada and khabar. Mubtada and khabar both will match in the case endings. That means haraka. For example, they will be marfu. Both will be a marfu. Okay. Mubtada, khabar, both will be a marfu. In Arabic, we know that there are three harakats: fataha, kasara, dhamma. Then how about fatahatain, kasratain, dhammatain, ustad? Don't ask me the question now, because you know when al comes, it's a dhamma. When alif lam never come, then it's a dhammatain. Okay? So, only three things we have to worry about it. Fataha, kasara, dhamma. Fatahatain, kasratain, dhammatain, it depends on alif lam, whether it is ma'rifa and nakira. You may not aware this before, but now you aware about the nakira and ma'rifa. So you should be able to differentiate between dhammatain and dhamma. Okay. So there are three harakats. Status: dhamma, kasra, fataha. By default, all the words should take dhamma. Okay. If, for example, you are going to say like a pen, kalamu. Whether you want to say kalama, kalami, kalamu, you have to say kalamu. Why kalamu? Because by default, the Arabic words will take dhamma. Okay. Then how about the kasra and fataha? If any of the word takes fataha or kasra, means there should be a reason. Without reason, you can't give fataha or kasara to a Arabic word. What is the reason? We will learn it about later. But we will learn what are the scenarios kasra will come. What are the scenarios fataha, we will give fataha to a noun. Okay. So three information you should aware about it. Nominal sentence will have two parts. Mubtada, khabar, subject, predicate. Then the second information is mubtada will be a definite marifa, khabar will be a nakira, indefinite. Then third information is khabar, mubtada and khabar will be marfu. Marfu means dhamma or dhammatain. It depends on whether it is marifa or nakira. So you got these three information. Any doubts on this? Okay, if no doubt, we can go to our lesson. Exercise 3. Sorry. Exercise 3, we have to fill in the blank space with the suitable words from the top. There are some words has given here. Jamilun is a beautiful. Wasikhun is a dirty. Maftuhun, open. Harun, hot. Faqilun, heavy. Khafifun, light. Correct? Okay. Now you have to choose the suitable word and fill in the blank. Al-Hajaru, what? You write it down?
Thaqeelun.
You write it down? Because everyone has to do. If you are writing down on your book, then use the pencil. If notebook, you can use the pen. 10 seconds. This is a 1, 2, 3, you see? /3, double R. 4. W, you have to standing W is 4. 5, actually, if you put the artin upside down right, is a 5. 6, 2 is 1 and right hand side 1 R. 6 is right hand, left hand side. Okay. Al-Babu dash, fill. Al-Qamaru dash. Al-waraku. Waraku means paper. Dash. Al-mindilu, handkerchief. Dash. Al-labanu, the milk, is dash. So you choose the suitable answer and fill the blank. Imla means fill. Al-Farag means blank. Okay, this one leave it as with the suitable letter. Fill in the blank with the suitable letter. Into the WhatsApp group. Yes, you sent it into the group once you are done. Okay, so we say Al-Hajaru, the stone is thaqeelun, heavy. Here, al-hajaru is a subject which we are going to talk. Thaqeelun is the information. So this sentence have as we learned, every nominal sentence will have two parts. One is subject, another one is information. Okay, so subject in English, if we have to say in Arabic, we have to say mubtada'un, mubtada. Information, the predicate is in Arabic khabar. Thaqeelun is a khabar. Okay. Al-babu, the door is maftuhun opened. Mubtada khabar. Al-qamaru, the moon is jamilun, beautiful. Mubtada khabar. Al-waraqu, the paper is khafifun, light. Mubtada khabar. Al-mindilu, wasikhun, dirty. The handkerchief is dirty. Khabar. Al-labanu, the milk is hot. Hot. Okay, in this sentence, right, only we have a two words. So we will know, okay, this part is mubtada and this part is khabar. Usually, a nominal sentence may have multiple, more than two words, correct? In that case, how we will say, for example, this is Ram's new house in London. How do you identify which part is mubtada, which part is khabar? Okay, very easy. You look at the, okay, I'm giving you another information, another sentence here, the same sentence, huh? Means house in India is very big and beautiful. Two sentences, huh? You just assume this is the Arabic word, huh? Then how do you identify which part is mubtada and which part is khabar? It's easy. The keyword is. The keyword is. Even in English, the words before is subject, mubtada, okay? The words after is, or sometimes it's all right, is or are, not war, A-R-E-R. Khabar, after the is, will be a, the portion will be a khabar. So similarly in Arabic, you translate and you see where you can put the is and are. Then the before, whatever words we are, you have a set of word before is, right, is a mubtada, and those words after is a khabar. Understand? Is it confusing? Usually a grammar is boring. Bring a sleep. Okay. So this is the mubtada and this is the khabar. This is the mubtada, this is the khabar. Because the keyword is. You see, al-hajaru, the stone is beautiful. So before is a mubtada, after is a khabar. Just to identify. So you look at the keyword is or are. Next exercise. In this exercise, they omitted khabar and they asked us to choose it from the given words, suitable words as for the khabar of each sentences. In next exercise, mubtada has been not given. So you have to give, and here they never give you a keywords also. Let's see how you are going to do this. Imla il faraga fi ma yali bi wada'i kalimatin munasibatin. It's just filling the blank. But the difference from the previous exercise and this exercise is here mubtada has been hidden, removed. You have to fill up. And the difficult part is no keywords has been given. In previously, there are some keywords has been given. You have to just choose it. But here you have to fill it from your knowledge. Try how good you are doing it. Just do until 5. Then the rest I will teach you. Just do until here. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Al qamisu nadifun. You have to put al, okay? Because it is mubtada. Al qamisu nadifun. The shirt is clean. The shirt is clean. Then the second one, al qalamu maksurun. Al qalamu maksurun. Al qalamu. You have to say qalamu. Here you have to put nadifun, dhammatain, maksurun, because it is nakira. If there is no alif lam, you have to put the tanwin. If got alif lam, no need to put, just dhamma. So ma'arifa al-qalam, al-qalamu, al-qamisu, al-qalamu, maksurun. The pen is broken. Then here, you can say baridun. We have learned al-ma'u, al-labanu. You can put anything, but you have to start with al. Al-ma'u baridun, al-labanu baridun, whatever it is. Al-ma'u baridun. We can say, we can use al-labanu harun. The milk is hot. Qaribun. You can say al-baytu qaribun, al-masjidu qaribun. Here, ba'idun, far, distance. Al-baytu ba'idun. Al-masjidu qaribun. We will make it the other way. In the lesson we have learned, al-baytu qaribun, al-masjidu ba'idun. House is near and masjid is far. We will make it other way. Masjid is near, house is far. Al, you have to start with al. Then waqifun. Al-mudarrisu waqifun. At-talibu waqifun. At-jalisun. Similarly. At-tabibu jalisun. Al-muhandisu. Muhandis means, we have learned, is a engineer. Al-muhandisu. Jalisun. Kabirun. You can say al-hajar. Al-hajaru. Hajaru. Kabirun. The stone is big. Next, qadimun. Al-baytu qadimun. Al-kitabu qadimun. Al-qalamu qadimun. Jadidun. You can use it. Same thing. Al-baytu jadidun. Al-qalamu jadidun. Al-kitabu jadidun. You can use it anything, but what you have to be very careful with is mubtada should start with alif lam and the khabar should end with tanwin, because nakira should have tanwin. Even when you read, that's why I'm asking for your recording. When you read, right, you have to be careful with tanwin and without tanwin. If alif lam, you should not do tanwin. If no alif lam, then you have to do tanwin. If you do either thing is against, right, the other way, it is wrong. Next. Al-Kalimatul Jadidatu. New words. Al-Kalimatul. Here the li is missing, okay? You can write it Kali. Kalimatul Jadidatu. If you look at the previous lesson, right, you can notice it. Kali, you see, there is a lam. Kalimatu. This lam is missing there. Huh? Al-Kalimatu Jadidatu. Jadida means new. Kalimat means words. Al-Qamaru, moon. The moon, okay? Al-Qamaru means the moon. We should not translate as a moon. Jadidun, new. You see, here Dhamma time. Why? Alif Lam? No Alif Lam. Marifa, Nakira. Qadimun, old. Vasikhun, dirty. Nadifun, clean. Harun, hot. Baridun, cold. Saghirun, small. Kabirun, big. Maftuhun, open. Maksurun, broken. Thaqilun, heavy. Khafifun, light. Jamilun, beautiful. Waqifun, standing. Jalisun, sitting. Okay. What else we have learned so far? Nakira and Marifa. Najumun, An-Najum. This is just recap what we have learned so far in this lesson 3. Najumun, star. A star. An-Najmu, the star. This is indefinite, definite. Nakira, Ma'rifa. Rajulun, Ar-Rajulu. A man, the man. Deekun, Ad-Deeku. Rooster, a rooster, the rooster. Twalibun, At-Twalibu. A student, the student. So, we have learned this so far in Lesson 3. Lesson 3 continues some more. Okay. Next. Actually, in the book, the page is swapped. Okay. Sorry, in the scan is the 1818. 17. But in the scan PDF, if anyone taken the printout from the PDF, right, you have to swap the page. We have to learn the 17 first, then go to the 18. 17 and 18 is swapped. Okay. An-Najmu Ba'idun. The star is far. An-Najmu Ba'idun. The star is far. Mubtada Khabar. Ar-Rajulu Waqifun. The man is standing. Sukkaru. As-Sukkaru Hulwun. Hulwun. We have learned halwa, sweet. As-sukkaru hulwun, sugar. The sugar is sweet. At-talibu maridun. The student is sick. Ad-diku jamilun. The rooster is beautiful. Ad-daftaru jadidun. The notebook, daftar is a notebook. Jadidun, the notebook is new. At-tajiru ghaniyun. Tajir means merchant, seller. Ghaniyun, rich. The merchant is rich. Ad-dukkanu maftuhun. Dukkan means shop, the shop. The shop is opened. Maftuhun, opened. Open, don't put ind, O-P-E-N, open. Al-Waladu Faqirun, the boy, Al-Waladu means boy, Faqirun, poor. At-tuffahu ladidun. Tuffah means apple. Ladidun, delicious. The apple is delicious. Sukkar vino, hulvun vino. Maridun is a sick. New word. Maridun, sick. Deek, we knew it. Rooster. Daftaru means notebook. Tajir. Dukkan means shop. Baladu boy. Faqirun, poor. Ghani, I think we have learned it earlier. Ghani means rich. Faqirun, poor. Tuffah, apple. At-tuffahu, the apple. Ladidun, delicious. Both new words. At-tuffahu, apple. Ladidun, delicious. Okay. The rest, everything is we knew. Let's read this together without the meaning. And you see whether you can understand the meaning. If you don't understand the meaning of any word, you underline it. Later, you have a look on that word to familiarize with it. Okay? Shall we start? Oh, sorry. There is another one word sentence here. At-tabibu tawilun. The doctor is tall. Tawil means doctor. Sorry. Tawil means tall. Tabib means doctor. Al-mudarrisu. The teacher is qasirun. Qasirun means short. Tabibu, doctor. Tawilun, tall. Al-mudarrisu. Teacher, qasirun, short. The doctor is tall and the teacher is short. Okay, shall we read together? Read it loudly. No worries. If you do any mistakes, we are in the learning stage. We can correct it. An-najmu ba'idun. Ar-rajulu waqifun. If you read it as ar-rajulun waqifu, it's wrong. Ar-rajulu waqifun. If you read it, ar-rajulu waqifu, wrong. Because nakira should have tanween. Reading also, you have to make sure. Ar-rajulu waqifu, wrong. Waqifun is correct. As-sukkaru hulvun. As-sukkaru hulvun. At-talibu maridun. At-talibu maridun. Ad-diku jamilun. Ad-diku jamilun. Ad-daftaru jadidun. Ad-daftaru jadidun. At-tajiru ghaniyun. At-tajiru ghaniyun. Ad-dukkanu maftuhun. Al-waladu faqirun. Al-waladu faqirun. At-tuffahu ladidun. At-tuffahu ladidun. At-tabibu tawilun. Wal-mudarrisu qasirun. At-tabibu tawilun. Wal-mudarrisu qasirun. Khair. Alhamdulillah. Any doubts? If no doubts, we can move to next exercise. Tamarin. Exercises. Here, again, same. Iqra waktub ma dhabati awakhir al-kalimati. We have to read and write by mentioning the haraka, ending of the haraka, ending of the word. That means putting the haraka. Al-babu. Al-babu, the door. Babu. All here, all ma'rifah. So we should not put tanmeen. All these words are ma'rifah because everything starting with alif lam. We should not put tanmeen because it is ma'rifah. Al-babu, the door. At-tajiru, The merchant, An-Najmu, star, the star, Al-Qamaru, the moon, Ad-Diku, the rooster, Al-Ma'u, the water, As-Sarru, the bed, Al-Baytu, the house, Al-Masjidu, the mosque, Ar-Rajlu, the man, As-Sukkaru, Sukkaru, Shadda, As-Sukkaru, the sugar, Al-Waraku, the paper. Okay, khair, alhamdulillah. Next, you take this as a exercise. You have already have a last week exercise, and this one also I think better you do it. Yes, I think it's just six only. Same, Mubtada has been removed, missing. You have to fill in the Mubtada. Imla means fill. Imla means fill. Imla. When you read Imla'il. Imla'il. Faragh. Faragh means empty, blank. Fill in the blank. Blank space. Okay. Ghaniyun. Here all. Mubtada has been removed, missing, omitted. You have to fill in that Mubtada. Ghaniyun. Rich. Maridun. Sick. Tawilun. Tall. Hulwun. Sweet. Ladidun. Delicious. Qasirun. Short. Okay. Inshallah, next week we will, I think one more, let's have. So take this as a home request. Next up, we go to next page. If you are using printed from PDF, you go to the previous page. Okay, here is like you have to match the words. Like section A, set of words. Section B has the set of the word. You have to just match. I think it's interesting. At-Talibu, the student, matching word. Ladidun, Maksurun, Saqilun, Maftuhun, Maridun. Okay, match it. At-Dukkanu, the shop. Ladidun. Delicious, maksurun, broken, thaqilun, heavy, maftuhun, open. Do it for other four. Okay? That's it. I think three things you have to do in this week. Last week homework is this portion. Oh, sorry. Read and write. Iqra waktub. This portion. You have to read and write. Record and send it to me. Then, last week, this week, two things. Page number 18. Imla'il faragha fi ma'ali. You have to fill in the blank space with meaning. Both with meaning, and this one I think you can do it later. It's just pointing another four or five. You could have after once you have done with this class, right? 5-2 minutes you can do it, just matching it. That's it for now. If you don't have any doubt, we can close off for today. Inshallah, we will see tomorrow.